Hello and welcome, people. Just give me a second and we'll get things started up here. Okay. Right, okay, hello and welcome, people. I'm Simply Scott, and today we're going to be doing a three-leg journey from up here in Sumburgh, in the Shetland Isles, and we're going to travel from here to Dyce Airport in Aberdeen. Then from Dyce, we're going to fly down to London. We're going to be stopping it in at Gatwick. And then from Gatwick, we're going to go across to Guernsey in the Channel Islands. So it's going to be quite an adventure. I'm looking forward to it. So you will also need to bear with me because I've only ever flown the ATRs once. And that was pretty much just to test them out, so I may not get everything 100% right. And I don't have a checklist to follow. I really should have got that ready before I started this, but we'll give it a go and see how we get on. So I'll just turn the beacon light off because we don't need that. You will have to bear with me because I haven't, like I say, haven't flown this much. So it's still kind of new to me. So prop brake on. Okay, so that's all looking good. I'll come down to the MCDU. Sorry, I'm probably not explaining what I'm doing very well. I'm concentrating quite a bit because, like I say, I've not really flown this plane before. So we'll get position in it done. Units. Performance. Cruise altitude for today is going to be 14,000 feet. Cruise return. V speed, so if we go across the tablet, performance 104, 104, and 110. So 104. 104. Oh god, I've forgotten what the last one was already. 110. 110. 110. So today we are going EGPB, EGPB to EGPD, EGPD. Execute that. Okay, and we are going to be leaving from runway 27. And from there we're going to Ravdi. RABDI. And we're coming into Aberdeen according to what we've got, localizer 16. Okay, so okay, that's looking 16. Yep. Yeah, that's looking good. So, here's hoping. So I've got that set up. What next? And I'm completely doing this from memory. than what I'd done last time to get into the sky. And I did successfully get it into the sky, so that's a forward jet. Yeah, that's okay. Start B. Open bomb. Start one. Looking like two good engine starts. Well, prop brake doesn't apply to that one. Interesting. Should have had the beacon light on. Nav light on. Local lights can go on. It's starting to be a taxi and take off. Yep. Measures, heavy arm, fasten seat belts, no electronic devices, temperatures are looking okay. Oxygen on, prop brake can come off. ATC's that talked to us. We're having a bit of trouble here getting it. Getting this prop brake to stop.
Aberdeen Airport is filed. Take off runway 15 climb and maintain 10,000 feet. Departure on 119.875 squawk 2452. Logan 81 reback correct. Contact ground on 118.255.
I'm having real trouble getting this prop brake to...
Sumburgh ground Logan 81 requesting pushback. Logan 81 pushback request accepted. Five when ready. 62 and hold short runway 15 via taxiway Kilo Logan 81.
Okay, I don't know what I've done, but it seems to have got us both props running. Sort of stopped it. Get taxis now, so take chocks away. Right, we're on the move.
Contact Scottish Centre on 119.875. Good day.
Bit of a crosswind. I probably should have actually taken off from 15. Maybe put into the wind a bit more, but hey-ho. I've just realised as well, I've not set up an autopilot. I Probably should have done that. Altitude. We're going up to 14,000 feet. This could be a complete disaster, but we'll find out. Look how close we are to the water here. Isle of Shetland. Shetland Isle, whatever it's called. Oh, I don't see you've crashed on me. Oh, we started there. Probably gonna crash. Problems with the throttle setup. I thought I had it set up, but clearly not. We'll see how it does when we take off. Okay, so we're all set up, I think. Okay. Can't be autopilot just now, that's fine. So let's throttle. of speed. Just can't get his throttle to work. Nope. I just can't seem to get that throttle to work. I don't know what it is. You know what, I may do this leg. As much as I want to try the ATR, it's... I think it's because I'm using an Xbox controller, in all honesty. I need to get myself a proper stick. Right, let's try not doing it in hotel mode and we'll just start it up. I'll turn the beacon light off first because it's somehow always on by default. Start on the battery. External power. And get the hydraulics up. Hydraulics on. Put the MON oxygen on. Windshield heating, we'll leave that for just now. And the emergency lights. Bright annunciator lights, seatbelt. Can go on, no devices can go on. Logo light can go on. Fuel pumps, start A and B, turn the gens on, we'll get a fault because the engine's not running. Let's start two. Right, MCDU again, in it, position in it, turn map data, weights, okay, performance in it, cruise altitude is 14,000 feet. Max cruise. Don't have an alternative for today. Wait, is that fine? Fuel flow. Yeah, it's fine. Right, so performance 104, 104 and 110, same as last time. 104, 104, 110, isn't it? Yep. That's that. MSFS 1, and it flight path. So we are going from EGPB, EGPB to EGPD. Yep. Oh no. Okay, and in between we are going to our ABDI. Rabbit. Rav Dai. Okay, and at EGPB, I think we might actually go for runway 15. Seeing the way the wind is. I'm just looking. Yeah, I think we'll go runway 15. Coming into localizer 16. Yep. Clear disk. Okay, that's all looking good. And you. Flight ID. Okay. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Let's set up the autopilot before we forget again. So climbing to 14,000 feet. That's fine. Let's go back overhead. External power's on. Generator's got fault though. Let's start engine one. Two engines started. Okay, let's go back to the overhead. External power can go off. Here, aircraft, ground power can go off. Wheel chocks can come away. Let's go back above. They're all looking good. Oh, should have had the beacon lights on before now. Oh well, taxi lights on. Strobe won't go on yet, local lights are on. Wing lights now. Yeah, we're looking good. I think we're safe to taxi. And we're taking off from runway 15 this time. So it looks like we need to backtrack up the runway a little bit. That's no problem. We're good to go. Okay. Right, okay, I think I might have the throttle set up. It's a bit of a... Okay, a bit of a sketchy takeoff there, but we're in the air nonetheless. We appear to be on course.
Clear to land runway 15 at 9.
I wasn't expecting to have all the stuff in the way. Is there, yeah, not stuff, it was hills. It was quite a high high terrain, that's the word I'm looking for. Quite high terrain taking off there. I wasn't totally expecting that, taking off from Shetland, I must admit. But I've never taken off from Shetland before, so I wouldn't know. Nonetheless, we are in the air. We are climbing. It's not going to be a very scenic flight because it's mostly all ocean. we are maybe climbing a bit steep. Although we should probably go back to climb. I don't know if that makes much of a difference setting that to climb, but we'll do it anyway. Coming up to a layer of clouds. Where are we at? 5,000 feet. It's a beautiful plane, I must admit. I've been looking forward to this getting released for a long time. I think it's almost 2 years it's been in the making, and it's now finally released, and I'm so happy. It's a brilliant little aircraft. Still got taxi and takeoff light on. We don't need that anymore. And that should be turned to off. A few wee things catching us out. And that's us above 10,000. We can turn off the landing lights. Climb on up to 14,000. I'm hoping we're going to break through these clouds at 14,000. Don't really want to be flying through the clouds. In the clouds. 12,000 feet. We might break through the tops of them. Maybe. I don't really want to go any higher than 14,000 feet because, well, it's a very short flight. I think flight time's meant to be about 30 minutes or so. Us technically turn on to the approach for Aberdeen or Dice already. There's no more waypoints, so here we come up to 14,000. Need to get ready just to pull back the throttle once we do get to 14,000. Yeah, I definitely think having an Xbox controller's confusing the throttle on this. I think I need to look at getting... I've been looking at getting the... what is it? It's just the flight stick. Well, I can't think of the name of it, that's terrible. But it's not going to come out. Last year maybe it came out. And it looks really good, and it's not overly expensive, it's like £120, so it's not bad. I might need to look into getting that shortly. Anyway, we're in the cruise. We can turn off the seatbelts and devices. Sit back and enjoy the view of that beautiful rainbow. Wow, look at that. Isn't that just spectacular? Anyway, yeah, we'll drive a nice little flight through these clouds. I think I'm going to go up and turn on are, to be honest. This is turning into quite a flight in darkness. hopefully the closer to land we get, we'll break up the clouds a bit. So our next leg is obviously going to be from Dyce down to Gatwick. That'll take a little while. I think we'll use the A320 for that flight. I haven't flown the A320 in some time, so it'd be nice to get back into it. I do enjoy it. I would like to experiment with either the Phoenix or probably the fly-by-wire first. I think fly-by-wire is the one to start with and then work your way up to the Phoenix. I have played about with a fly-by-wire A320, but I've never experimented too much with it, so that's something I need to do shortly. But I am enjoying this ATR. I can see me spending a lot of hours flying this ATR. Is I have had a flight in the ATR. I did get up into the sky and fly around for a bit, but I haven't actually landed it yet. So this landing live on stream tonight is going to be my first ever landing in the ATR. So it could be a disaster. It could be an absolute disaster, in fact. Here we go, the clouds are breaking up a wee bit more, got a bit better view. Still just clouds, but it's, we can see something. Lucky person in this seat, looking out into that turboprop engine. All you can see is that turboprop engine and some clouds. Hey, not a bad place to be sitting, flying from the Shetland into Aberdeen. Just going to have a look on Little Nav Map. Little Nav Map is where I create all my flights. So when we get to the next checkpoint, waypoint even, we want to be at 2300. Yep, 2300 foot for the next waypoint. So once we come to top of descent, we'll go down to 2300 and then pretty much from there we'll catch the localizer. Oh, there's the rain. typical Scottish flight this, eh? 14,000 feet in the air, and it's raining on us. Ugh, it could be worse. And the ice knife put on works. Let's have a look up top again, actually at cabin temperature. Oh, we're up to 30. We're heating up a little bit. Quite hands-on, you know, I'm having to adjust the throttle now and again, just because it doesn't have the auto-throttle or auto-thrust as an Airbus would have. So you do have to man the throttle and make sure that you don't overspeed. But it's enjoyable. Empty, which, well, no pilot can go with an empty beer, so I'll go get a beer top up, and by the time I get back, we should be nearing the top of descent, and we'll start heading down and see how the landing goes in Aberdeen. That's going to be interesting. Anyway, catch you in a minute. Okay, people, that's me back. Fresh new beer out of the fridge. Ready to land this bird. We're actually still quite a bit off top of descent, according to the nav map. I'm not sure if top of descent shows up on this. I've not played about with all these instruments and stuff. Doesn't seem to be modelled on this, I don't think. This is definitely what you'd expect in a flight in from the island of Shetland into Aberdeen. Hopefully it's a bit clearer once we get down into Aberdeen. It's 25 past 10 in the morning, so we should hopefully get some good weather when we get down. We'll fly in 27 minutes, so yeah, 40-50 minute flight, I think, by the time we land. Some blue skies getting closer. Oh, if I put this into cruise. No. Maybe a bit late to be doing that now, but we'll put it into cruise. Keep forgetting about that. I'm not sure what exactly it changes, but never mind. So I need to remember, as we approach top of descent, we'll turn on the seatbelt light again. And start rolling down. We are going down to, let's say, 2,300 feet we're going down to. Starting the descent in about 5 minutes, I think. Here we go, above the clouds, blue skies. So hopefully once we're down below them clouds, it's blue skies and a nice landing in Aberdeen. Okay, so 2,300 feet. 2,300 feet. We'll go up above, we'll turn the seatbelt sign on. And I think we'll just start lowering now. We need to get our landing lights on. Here we go. View's coming in. Once we're below this cloud layer, I think we can turn anti-icing off. We shouldn't have any more icing problems. Fit. It's just past 4,000 feet. Plane starting to level itself out, I think. It's just within 1,000 feet. So we're going to come in just about right. Power in and I assume we can all go off now. It's maybe a bit early turning all the anti-icing off, but hey ho. Is the glide slope coming in? And we're turning, and we should be about to pick up the localizer. I think if we turn to. Yep. We should be able to pick up the localizer. What's it doing? I don't think it's quite ready to pick up the localizer. Could be an interesting landing. Hopefully we catch the localizer this time. Nope. this is going to be an interesting landing. Flaps down. You know what, I think a temporary
too low terrain 500.
Oh shit, boys, we're going down.
100 150. Don't sink. Sink rate. 200. Don't sink.
Well, we're fucked up, boys. Well and truly screwed that up. Well, what can I say? Other than we royally fucked that up. Anyway. Oh, what do we do from here? Do we do that flight again? As much as it was enjoyable, it was a lot of cloud. Or do we put that down as a failure? Say we crashed and burned, there was a massive accident. Cummins Park in Aberdeen. And the A320 were due to be flying down to Gatwick still goes ahead and we still fly down to Gatwick. I think we'll go ahead and fly down to Gatwick, to be honest. We may redo that flight again some other time, but not today. So A320, easy jet. And like I say, I use a little nav map, so dice to Gatwick. This should be a relatively straightforward flight, surely. Surely, there can't be anything goes wrong with this flight. I didn't check what the time was. I'm recording this in the evening, but obviously it's the same day I'm flying, I just fly earlier on in the day. Just makes things a little bit easier. Now, again, long time since I flew this plane. So, bear with me. I will get... This is where I want to be. This is where I want to be. Now, how the hell do we start this thing again? Well, we want some batteries, I'd imagine. But you know this? Can't even fucking mind where the batteries are. Batteries, one and two, on. External power. Do we want external power? Let's go for it. Get APU on. Okay, that's coming on. Our flight plan looks to be automatically, automatically put in. All good stuff. Now, wipers don't do anything, but they're there and make an annoying sound. Okay, so let's look outside. APU is obviously running. Today we are going to be taking off on runway 16. So let me just see how we taxi there. Pretty simple, I think. Yep. Quite straightforward, and it actually looks like we're taking off runway 16 is going to be a good idea. So are we ready for engine start? I have no idea. Turn the ground power off. Turn off the white lights. Oh yeah, better set up the autopilot. So we're going to 24,000 foot. We're going high, boys. We're going high. Speed selected altitude. Hello, on the way out, do we have altitude above 1000? Okay, so yeah, looks like we can just head right on up to 24,000. Okay. We're going to need a pushback.
Aberdeen Ground EasyJet 900 requesting pushback.
Aberdeen Ground EasyJet 900, no pushback tug, is available to answer your request.
Well, ain't that just sweet? That is just tickety-boo, as I should be saying. Let's get engine 2 fired up. Which isn't happening for some reason. Okay, what have we forgotten? Forgot the APU bleed, that was helpful. Okay, to go. Is the APU off? Sorry again, I haven't flown in so long. When I am flying, I have to concentrate so much on what I'm doing that I don't even realise I'm not talking until later on. And I'm like, yeah, I've not said much in a while. You know, it's a. I'm new to the streaming as well, so that'll take a little bit of getting used to it. Oh, that van's gone. So anyway, yeah, we're just going up here and we'll be taking off. Heading for Gatwick in London, if nobody knows. So we'll get this up into the air. It should be straightforward. There shouldn't be any problems. Other than this awful weather we're taking off in. It's just not great at all. And of course we'll have the assistance of all thrusters in the Airbus. That'd be nice. Can't see anything, it'd probably be an ILS. Well, it is an ILS landing situation. We're not landing, we're taking off. Thankfully we've got GPS to follow, otherwise we wouldn't care where the hell we were going, would we? And we're going up high enough that the weather shouldn't be a problem. Although I will have to put anti-icing on for taking off, because it's real ice up in this. Okay, here we go for takeoff. Wasn't too bad of a takeoff for me, to be honest, in the Airbus, considering it's probably a good six months probably since I last flew it. It's not bad, considering. Let's get gear up, flaps up.
500.
Like I was saying earlier on in the stream, I mean, it's been a bit of a lengthy stream for me, but this is just the default A320, and I would like to try again with the fly-by-wire. I think that would a lot more immersive anyway. This is a bit push a couple of buttons, you're in the air and away you go sort of thing. So I'd like to get a bit more practice in with them and get a bit more in depth with that. There's Aberdeen just behind us. So yeah, that's probably the next thing I'm going to do. First of all, I'm going to get more practice in the ATR. Loving the ATR, just can't fly it very well. But practice will help out with that. So lots of practice in the ATR, and then have another look at the fly-by-wire. I think the fly-by-wire is still highly rated. I'm not sure with recent updates and stuff. I know the Fenix, of course, is like, it's as good as it can get for Airbus anyway. So. It's expensive as well, the Fenix. I mean, I don't grudge the price of the Fenix, because for what it is and the work that's went into it, it's worth it, I would say. I just don't know if I'd be willing to spend that much on an aeroplane for a flight simulator at the moment. I also have the Osprey. I've downloaded the Osprey. I bought the Osprey, downloaded it. I've done one or two flights, but I mean, it's a bit of a beast to try and learn. That is a huge learning curve. That's one that I'm going to need to sit down and read the manual on before I even think about. Well, actually, no, I've already thought about taking it to the skies. But yeah, before I get successful with it, I'm going to need to read the manual for that one. I hope when I'm talking I'm not shouting. I'm just thinking, because I've got a headset on, sometimes, you know, when you've got a headset on you don't hear yourself very well. It's like, well, I'm in a flat and I've got neighbours, so I hope that I'm not shouting into the mic. But no, I seem to be just talking normal. Maybe a bit louder, actually. Yeah, maybe you should tone down that. Anyway, looks like we're clearing the weather. Not much more ahead of us, so I think the anti-icing can go off. We're 17,000 foot, 18,000 foot, still a bit to go. So because this is, I haven't had to program this in, which has helped, it saves a bit of time. I mean, we're approaching 2 hours on this stream and we've only just left Aberdeen. We should have probably been at Gatwick probably about now. But the ATR caused us a few problems and there we go, 20,000 feet. I don't fly airliners much at all. I like the GA sort of flying. But I want to get into airliners a bit more. I do like the idea of flying airliners. It's just short hauls. That's how the ATR, when I heard about the ATR, I was like, yes, I need to get the ATR because it is perfect for them short haul flights, and especially in the UK, you know, just little hops across to Ireland, Scotland to England, you know, Edinburgh to Glasgow. I don't even know if they'd actually I don't know if they do that sort of distance in the UK. I know, obviously I'm from Scotland, in case the accent hasn't given it away, but Logan Air fly the ATRs, so I do know they do, like, so what we've just done, like, Sumburgh to Dice is an actual route that Logan Air fly, which is the reason I had the Logan Air livery, and all of that, you know, and it's like Dice to Gatwick is an actual EasyJet route, hence I'm flying an EasyJet A320, it's a real life route. And also, once we get to Gatwick, if we make it to Gatwick tonight, that is, we'll be flying another ATR from Gatwick across to Guernsey, which again is a real life route. So that is us up at cruising altitude. And we can kick back and relax for a bit. I don't think this has even the depth of seatbelt light. Oh yeah, probably should have done that. No smoking will put on though. I missed them. Oh well, hopefully everyone had their seatbelt on. Well, we'll just assume that everyone did have their seatbelt on and everything's alright back there. Yeah, I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure all the passengers are hunky-dory. Anyway, we're approaching Perth, or the PTH. Word's gone again. Anyway, we're coming across Schoon. Some people might know where it is. Not much of a view down below. Quite cloudy, but anyone that knows the Perth area, Perth City, that's down there somewhere. River Tees, down there somewhere as well. Dundee. Been 24,000 feet. So a wee bit of cloud about. I think we'll be alright though as far as ice and conditions. Hopefully. We'll find it. So we will just let autopilot do the majority of this work. We're landing as well. We're we're ILS landing as well, so we're we can pretty much let the Airbus just do the whole flight for us, which is nice after fighting with ATR a bit. Very cloudy over Scotland today. It has been quite a cloudy day actually in real life. Rain showers and just quite dull the whole day, so yeah, it's I think live weather's working correctly at the moment anyway. Now if we look out below, may be able to see River Forth. Which I think we can make a bit out down there through the clouds. Not 100% sure. Could be anything. Obviously then we see Queen the Forth. Pretty much find Edinburgh. Well, the clouds are easing up a little bit. So, is that Dunfermline? It is, it's Dunfermline. And then we can see the bridges there. The three bridges. Rail bridge, road bridge, and the Queen's Crossing, is it called? Oh god, I can't even remember. Yeah, three pretty famous bridges. The rail bridge is, I think everyone knows about the Forth Rail Bridge. Big Red Bridge, it's a beautiful bridge, an amazing piece of engineering. Queen's Ferry Crossing, that's the new one. That's the one on the far right that we can see from here. I actually had a boat trip on the Forth and we saw the foundations or the pillars of it being dropped into the bottom of the river, which was quite interesting. definitely something nice to see. So yeah, there's Queen's Ferry across the bridges. So yeah, I think this is, yeah, it's Dunfermline down below us, 24,000 feet below us. And over just under all this cloud here, maybe just starting to come into sight, is Edinburgh. But we're not landing in Edinburgh today. Yeah, we've got quite a distance to go after Edinburgh. Another 440 miles, to be precise. Yep, that's Edinburgh down below there. Beautiful city. I need to explore Edinburgh a bit more actually. It's a lovely, lovely city. Anyway, let's get back into the flight deck. Cockpit, even. Flight deck, cockpit, whatever you want to call it. It's what it is, isn't it? Anyway, everything seems to be going fine. We're trundling along. Quite slowly, in fact, I don't know. I'm just playing about here really, see if I can get it to go a bit faster. I'm not completely sure how all these things work. We're fairly low going on. I don't think I can go much faster. Thank you. There we go, getting a bit of speed on. Pressure to 350. There we go. A little bit of speed just to get like a bit quicker. Anyway, people, because I am consuming alcohol beverages during this stream, I'm going to go in a. Well, I'm sure you know after you've had a few alcohol beverages where you need to visit. So I'm off there at the moment, and I will catch up with you shortly. I'll leave you an external camera so you can see the world whizzing by. See if you can spot anything of interest that I miss while I'm away. Let me know in the comments if I do. Okay, people, that's me back. Refreshments. So where are we? We're just coming up to... over Lake Windermere, okay. So yeah, we're motoring on. Just what we need. I think, I don't think we'll get to Guernsey tonight. I think I might need to end the stream once we get to Gatwick. We'll wait and see what the time is though, and if I can make it to Guernsey then I will of course continue the flight on to Guernsey. If not, we'll pick up from Gatwick and go to Guernsey in the next stream. You'll have to forgive me because I am not clued up on areas in England, so I won't be able to tell you all the landmarks we're passing, if we pass any, other than obviously the popular ones. I'll be able to point them out. But mostly I don't know much. I've not travelled in England too much. We'll stay in here just now in a see how things go. Quite a bit of cloud cover coming in actually. I'm hoping we don't need to put the icing on again, although I think we might. saw the... Yeah, it's pretty cold outside. I think we'll be okay just now without the icing. Not the icing. Certainly seem to be out with cloud cover just now. We're sort of flying between the clouds. Cloud layers. Manchester. So we're just approaching an hour into the flight. We're not doing bad, I'd say, yeah, we're over half the way. And Birmingham shortly, but there's far too much cloud to be able to spot it. Might get glimpses through the clouds, but not very much. According to a little nav map, I've still got an hour and 15 minutes before top of descent. I think little nav map auto generated the route, and I think it's taken quite a long route because, I mean, we're going East Midlands. I'm pretty sure there's flight routes that could have taken us down the coast, the east coast of the UK, and into London, but anyway, we'll take what's given us. Maybe I might do a bit more research and see what route the actual EasyJet flight from Dice to words are escaping me. Gatwick, that's where we're going. I might do research and look into what route the actual EasyJet flights from Dice to Gatwick take. Because I'm pretty sure from looking on flight radar and stuff, I'm pretty sure they go sort of like follow the east coast of the UK. I mean, it'd be a lot quicker than coming away across to, you know, past, well, we're away past Coventry, we're past Edinburgh, past Manchester. It's, we're a wee bit out of the way, I think. So over here someplace is Coventry. Can't see it. And Leicester, yeah, over there someplace. I'm not going to see it. Clouds far too thick to see anything. We're just coming up to an hour to top of descent. So let's just have a look at a little Navi map when we do eventually get to where we want to be. So top of descent, okay. So here we need to be below 220 knots. Nothing but attitude. Okay, so here we won't be down to 2000. Altitude restrictions at 7000 feet. So when we start top of descent, we want to be coming down to 7,000 feet to begin with. Yep. Top of descent's there. Yep. Down to 7,000 feet. Not exceeding 220 knots. Then it's down to 3,000, and then we'll be on to the. We'll capture the ILS at 3,000 feet. So when we come to top of descent, 7,000 feet. So we're actually just going to bypass London in a short while. But we're of course going to see none of London today because it's under a great big blanket of cloud. But had it been a clearer day, we would get great views of London. Definitely not going to see London today. Would have had to be lower down through that thick blanket cloud to be able to see London. But I don't think airbuses fly below clouds there very often. You know, I might be able to shove out just the Guernsey leg quickly. Might even use the twin hour. I like the twin hour. Let me know what you think. Should we use the twin hour to go to Guernsey? Or the ATR? I think ATR is what would normally make the flight, but I wouldn't mind doing it in the twin hour actually. They're very, very similar in, but they're twin. Twin propeller, twin otter is obviously a lot smaller, but I enjoy flying the twin otter. 2 hours actually probably the plane I've flown most since coming back to flight simulator. Had a wee break, from the PC altogether, to be honest. So coming back to flight simulator, it's all a bit new again, but I'm certainly picking it up. Clouds breaking a little bit. You can see parts of one thing down there. Something that interests me, but it's never perked my interest enough to actually try it. Honestly, I swear, anytime I need something, it's just not there. back inside. There's not much to see out there. So we're about 20 minutes away from top of descent now. Let me just double check with a little nav map that there's not speed restrictions coming in before I've noticed. No. For speed restrictions for a while. Probably throw on the seatbelt sign. Okay, let's slow it down a bit. That's us ready for top of descent, which is coming up shortly, about 9 minutes according to the nav map. So we've slowed the jet down a little bit. We've got our altitude ready at 7,000 feet, and we are ready just to engage 7,000 feet when we get to top of descent. I may start slightly earlier just to give myself a bit more time. I think we'll start lowering ourselves now. So while we're going down, we just need to keep an eye out for getting through clouds for the icing, and also main road at 19,000, but before 10,000 feet we'll need to put the landing lights on. I do forget about that quite often, which is quite an important thing actually. I don't know if it's everywhere in the world, but here in the UK below 10,000 feet you must have your landing lights on. For commercial flights, I'm not sure if it's the same for GA. So it's turning at Hasty, heading back in landward. And we're just coming down to 16,000 feet. Maybe slowed down a little bit too early, but our next waypoint is below 220 knots. So I've just set it for manual speed at 210 knots, so it keeps us below, but still a bit of speed up. I'm not going to drop flaps yet, I don't think. We're quite a bit away still. So yeah, no need for flaps anywhere near soon. Maybe once we get to Willow we'll start dropping flaps. So where are we? We're 12,500 feet, so yeah, we should be down well before we need to. Sorry about that alarm, that's just a reminder alarm for me. I should have turned that off actually, I totally forgot. So here we go down through the clouds. These are opening up now. 5,000 feet. Okay, control 8. So we need landing lights on. First stage of flaps. It could be very early, but it'll just help us a little bit. Just approaching 8,000 feet, 1,000 feet to go. So after Willow, we have down to 3,000 feet. So let's just have that ready, just in case we get busy. And from 3,000 feet, we should be able to intercept the ILS. Peace during the day. So once we pass Willow, we need to drop down to 3,000 feet. It's fine at 220, I believe. Yeah. So we're going to drop down now. Okay, hold on, something's gone wrong. Happened. Yep. Okay, so we've screwed up a bit. A big bit. Head into heading mode. See if we can fix this. So I'm hoping if we just
2,500.
Fly this manually, we will be able to land this successfully. Although I'm not 100% sure, this could be two flights in one stream that have gone disastrously wrong. Hopefully this picks up the ILS signal. If not, we might just need to fly it in manually, which could be another disaster.
Thousand five hundred. 2,500.
Just going for it. We're YOLO on it.
1,000.
Over speed. Over speed. Over speed. Over speed.
500.
Over speed.
400.
Over speed. Over
300.
Speed. Over speed. Over speed.
200. 100. 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, retard 5.
Boom! Two failures. Anyway guys, thank you for watching. As always, I appreciate it. But we're going to end things on that note. Again, if you enjoyed this, leave a like. It helps out greatly. Anyway, I'm going to practice some landings. I'll see you next time.